guys, Robert here, and welcome to episode 8 of season 5 of RobGioMegacollabs. Yep, that's right guys, we are at the season 5 finale, and for this episode, we're going to be ranking the Weeknd's 5th and most recent album, Dawn FM. So Dawn FM is an album that musically goes for the new wave and funk sounds of the 1980s, similar to much of his previous work. However, what makes this project separated from the rest of his work is its concept about being in a purgatory state while letting a radio host guide you to the light and helping you transition to the other side. On top of that, he recruited quite a bit of producers among the likes of Swedish House Mafia, Calvin Harris, and Oneohtrix Point Never. And it even contains narration from Jim Carrey and even spoken word appearances from Quincy Jones. And yeah, I cannot wait to rate this album with you guys. So 5 people have actually joined this episode, and those people are the YouTube Studios Fan 2022, Dark Strawberry, Miguel Sanchez, DJ Cams, and Helios Cheetos. So yeah, good roster of people here with us today, and now time for the disclaimers. Before we get started, please keep in mind that these rankings are based on our personal enjoyment and nostalgia, and are also based on our personal opinions as well, so our rankings might be different from yours. If you would like to let me know how you would rank the album, or would just like to let me know what your opinion on this album may be, just feel free to leave that down in the comment section down below. And yeah, I have no other fancy talk left for me to say without any further ado. It's Dawn FM, ranked from worst to best, as ranked by more than one person. Enjoy. And this time I know
for sure, don't break my heart. Number 16, Don't Break My Heart. Don't let me go, please, don't you break my heart. Don't break my heart. I don't know if I can take it anymore. Number 15, A Tale by Quincy.
And it's like raising kids, man. If you weren't raised, you don't know how to raise, you know? I just did the best thing I could with them because they know fucking well I love them.
Number 14, Dawn FM.
But what's the rush? Just relax and enjoy another hour of commercial-free music on 103.5 Dawn FM. Stay tuned.
Number 13, Every Angel is Terrifying.
Euphoric, provocative, edgy, thought-provoking, technically and visually stunning. A compelling work of science fiction.
Number 12, I Heard You're Married.
I heard you're married, girl. I knew that this was too good to be true. I heard you're married, girl. Oh.
Number 11, Best Friends.
To be responsible for your heart if you fall, 'cause I'll get clumsy and tear it apart. I love you so, but we can't get close.
Number 10, Phantom Regret by Jim.
It's long gone, and your phantom regret hasn't let it go yet. You may not have died in the way that you must. All specters are haunted by their own lack of trust. When you're all out of time.
Number 9, Is There Someone Else? Number 8, Starry Eyes.
Let me be there, I can be there until you're home. You weren't touched.
Number 7, Less Than Zero. Number 6, Here We Go, Again.
Ooh, here we go again. Life's a dream, 'cause it's never what it seems.
Number 5, How Do I Make You Love Me? Number 4, Out of Time.
Girl, but I'm out of time. Say I'm there for you, but I'm out of time. Say that I'm here for you, but I'm out of time.
Number 3, Sacrifice.
I don't wanna stand.
Number 2, Gasoline.
You spin me around so I can breathe. It's only safe for you and me. I know you won't let me OD. And if I find.
And finally, number 1, Take My Breath. So yeah, that was the ranking proper, and yes, thank you to everyone who has participated in this Mega Collab ranking. It is always greatly appreciated. And now it's time for me to say what I think about Dawn FM. And yeah, this album's awesome as always. While it doesn't necessarily beat After Hours as my favorite project from him so far, it comes very, very close. As such, I can definitely see why this album got widespread critical acclaim upon release. Not only is the production pristine as hell, but I just can't get enough of the existential and psychedelic themes scattered throughout this album, coupled with pure cohesiveness. And let me just tell you something, the highlights are almost as astounding as the ones on After Hours, I swear. Take My Breath and Sacrifice definitely deserve to get hits right there. And yeah, this is another one of those albums where every track is at least good. Like other tracks that didn't become as popular as those two tracks, like Here We Go Again and Less Than Zero. Those two tracks in particular, they're so freaking good. And again, like I mentioned seconds ago, a lot of the tracks are at least good. Even A Tale from Quincy, it still contributes to the overall atmosphere despite being nothing short of an interlude. So nothing much to say about this except this album's awesome. And it's so far in contention for the best album of 2022 so far. Easily top 10 favorite albums of 2022 right there. So, for the final time this season, let's see what some of you have to say. Opinion on the album is. If you do fill out that section, then your opinion will be in the next episode segment. Please note that one last section is also completely optional, so you really don't have to fill out that one last section, but filling it out is always greatly appreciated. Also, I give the participants an option to give this album a score out of 10, and as a result, their average rating for this album is an 8.2 out of 10. So yeah, that's gonna do it for season 5, episode 8 of Rob Geo Mega Collabs, the season 5 finale. And give yourselves a round of applause. All right. Thank you to everyone who has participated in season 5 of Rob Geo Mega Collabs. Whether you have joined all the episodes or joined a few episodes or just joined one episode, your support is greatly appreciated. And even though we obviously didn't get as much people as the last season, which was on Daft Punk, I'm still eternally grateful for like the amount of people who have participated. Even in instances we only got 4 people who participated, specifically in the Echoes of Silence Mega Collab, and even if we got 5 people for this episode, keep in mind that I only do this for the passion, and that's really it. So thank y'all for participating. You guys rule. Season 6 is going to be on the English electronic musician Tom Jenkinson, aka Square Pusher. The link to the form for his debut album, Feed Me Weird Things, will be in the description down below and also in the pinned comment as per usual. And the form will be closing on Sunday, July 10th, 2022 at 5 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. And I'm pretty much looking forward to seeing how many people participate in this, especially since we're technically going back to like all the electronic stuff again. And this is something that you don't want to miss out on if you're interested in like drill and bass and IDM and jazz fusion and jungle and all that other kind of stuff. So fill out the form if you're interested, links in the description, mid comments. And we've made it to the end of the video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, give it a like, share this one with your friends if you want to, and leave a comment down below. And as always, don't forget to subscribe as we're on the road to 7,000 subscribers. That's pretty much it, guys. Thank you for watching, and as always, I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye, guys.